Hey guys, what is going on? It is Daboki here once again, and it is time for a Maple Story video. I'm here filming my good friend Nikki, training her fourth job, Mihail, and I wanted to go ahead and show you some of the fourth job skills, because I will never be able to reach fourth job, and I thought it was unfair that you guys will never be able to see fourth job, so I was like, you know what? I'm gonna film my good friend here, hit some things in Monster Park PQ. So, she's level 145, and super strong, so I hope you guys will enjoy this video, but I want to go ahead and talk about dreams in this video, because dreams are really interesting, and I know all of you guys probably had at least one dream in your life, figuratively and literally, but I want to talk about a specific type of dream, of course, nightmares, because I don't really get nightmares anymore. I guess once you get older, you just stop getting nightmares, these bad dreams, but when you do, it's like, oh, you know, that was kind of freaky, but I'm not going to really cry about it. But I just remember when I was younger, like, I would seriously get these bad dreams, and I would wake up with tears streaming down my face, like, literally crying. And I was deathly afraid to go to bed. Like, how many of you guys were horrified to go to sleep at night, you know, because you just were afraid that you're going to have these nightmares and these bad dreams? And, you know, like, I know I'm not the only one that people have had horrible dreams, but I've had this dream that it would happen over and over again, like the same exact dream. And I was wondering, guys, did you guys ever experience this? Like, was there a dream that you had over and over again that was just so frightening? Like, I look back at it now, and it's just so silly I've had this dream. But, like, and I wanted to go ahead and share this dream with you guys because it was just so super silly, but it was so scary to me. And I wanted to maybe see what some of your guys' nightmares were that just kind of stuck out in your mind. So, anyway, this dream would always start out the same. I would spawn. Alright, let's use video game terms so we all know what we're talking about. I spawned in this location, the same location, the spawn points were rigged. I spawned on the pillars, alright, and there was a whole bunch of pillars around me, and I looked down and you could see nothing. There was just blackness, and these pillars were super high up. And I look over, and all the time when I look over in front of me, I would see the same gorilla staring back at me, and he was just looking at me, and he was hunched over with his knuckles on the pillars, and he was just looking at me. And then all of a sudden, right after I made eye contact with him, same thing all the time, after I made eye contact with him, I looked down into my hand, and boom, there was a yellow banana in my hand. And then I'd look back up and he was just charging me. And I'd be screaming, jumping on the pillars, trying to get away from him, not knowing what to do. And I was just crying and screaming. And then all of a sudden, right at like a split second, I'd end up in a teleporter and I'd wake up. And every time I had this dream, I had it a lot, I would have the exact same experience, and I'll just be waiting to get into that teleporter to wake up. Like, that was my freedom. I knew exactly what to look forward to in that dream. And it was just really weird, because every time I had that dream, I woke up with tears streaming down my face, clenching an invisible banana. It was just ridiculous, and I was just like, why was I so afraid of that gorilla? You know, he was probably just wanting the banana. I should just gave it to him. I didn't know why I didn't drop it or just hand it to him, you know, just a friendly monkey looking for some food. And I was like, no, I need to keep this banana. So that's one of my silly nightmares. And another silly nightmare that I just had once, but it's like one of those dreams you'll never forget. I remember just like spawning again at a party. I like to use the word spawn in dreams because you just randomly spawn. But I spawned at this like party, like this pool party. I don't know what I was doing at a pool party. And I was riding a bike around the pool, and then it was nighttime, so there was like lights. And then this werewolves came, and they attacked everyone at the party. And you know, like when a werewolf bites someone, I guess they change into a werewolf. I don't know how that works. Maybe that's vampires, but this werewolf, he was contagious, like a zombie werewolf, and he was biting everyone at the party, and they all turned into werewolves. And then he saw me, and then he came and he charged me and he bit me, right? I was like, okay, you can bite me, because I know I can't outrun a werewolf. I'm not dumb. So he bit me, and then all of a sudden, after a while, you know, I was like, okay, so I'm already bit, I'm a werewolf now, I'm like running around the party, I'm trying to bite people also, like a good werewolf would do. And then another werewolf came and they bit me again, and I was like, dude, I'm on your side, stop biting me, it hurts, you know, it's like, what are you doing to me? And he's like, you're not a werewolf yet. And I'm like, what do you mean I'm not a werewolf? Well, the thing is, guys, the reason why he didn't think I was a werewolf is because I didn't have any hair on my chest, you know what I mean? Like, I didn't have any hairy arms and stuff. And this is because I remember my mom telling me, in real life, not in the dream, like, Asian people just don't get a lot of hair on their chests or on their arms and stuff. They're just not hairy. So, like, In the dream, I was not hairy because Asian people just can't get hair like that. So I was like, I was trying to explain to the werewolf, like, have a logical conversation, saying that, no, you know, Asian people won't get hair on their chest. So I'm a werewolf. No, trust me, I'm a werewolf, but I just won't get hair. And this werewolf just wouldn't understand and just kept biting me. And it hurt so bad. I was like screaming. I was like, stop. You know, like, I'm sorry. It's my genes. I just can't grow hair. I literally physically can't grow hair on my chest, you know? So I'm an Asian werewolf. You know, you have to understand. And he just didn't trust me and just kept biting me until I woke up. And, like, my arm was falling asleep, and it just really was painful. So anyway, let me know if you've seen an Asian werewolf. That'd be excellent. Because I know what pain they're going through. But guys, yeah, so leave your dreams in the comment section below. I just want to go ahead and share that with you guys, because I just thought it was fun and interesting. But have you guys had any crazy nightmares? I'd love to see your nightmares. I'll read about them. But guys, like always, thank you so much for watching. This has been Deboki, and we'll be seeing you guys later. A silent. I don't know what that word means. I guess like a cross between an assistant and an assassin. That would be a very interesting